All right, our top focus. Months after the Doklam standoff between India and China was resolved, China has raised the issue with Bhutan. On his three-day visit to Thimpu, Chinese foreign minister discussed the boundary issue with the leaders of the Himalayan nation. China's foreign ministry spokesperson has said, and I quote, "The two sides exchanged views on China-Bhutan ties and boundary issues and reached many agreements. The meeting is of prominence considering the fact that China has no diplomatic ties with Bhutan. The nations have an unresolved border dispute that has spanned several decades now. The Doklam Plateau is the part of the disputed border where the boundaries of India, China and Bhutan meet. China has offered 269 square kilometers of the area in the western sector to Bhutan in lieu of 100 square kilometers of Doklam. Bhutan refuses to accept this. India and China were locked in an over two-month-long military standoff near their boundary in Doklam Plateau. The standoff began in June when Indian troops stalled a road building by the Chinese army in the area. The Indian Army cited the disputed status of the region and its close proximity to India's artery in the northeast. All right, for more on this, I'm joined by WION's correspondent who's joining us from Beijing. Gaurav Sharma joins us on the phone line. Gaurav, the timing of this visit is significant since polls are likely to be held in Bhutan in October. Please give us more details about what this visit is all about, the key agenda.
You know, if you remember, it was in August last year when the 72-day military standoff was resolved and both India and Chinese military, Indian and Chinese military retreated from the point of face-off. And again, this comes, just ahead of August. You know, this meeting just comes ahead of August. And Vice Foreign Minister Kong Xuanyou, who is actually becoming a very prominent leader in Chinese Mandarin. So, you know, you see, this is a very, very important meeting. And he was accompanied by Chinese ambassador to India. That's something which is, again, you have to take it very, very, it's a very important development. And China and Bhutan have held 24 rounds of talks over their disputed boundary. And this will be the 20th. And, you know, nothing has come off. But, you know, China has been trying to pressure and trying to coax Bhutan to agree to the largesse, which it has given in lieu of getting a Doklam, which is of high prominence because it is Bhutan, and it's a very, very near to the Siliguri corridor, which connects India's northeast with the rest of the country. So you have to see, and the foreign ministry spokesperson, the Chinese foreign ministry spokesperson, also said that a number of agreements were clinched between both the countries. However, when we asked it what kind of agreements they were, he actually specifically told us there was no agreement on the boundary, but there were some important agreements. So this is a very, very important visit, and it's saying that the boundary issue was discussed. It goes without saying that Doklam also figured in the meeting. And the foreign ministry, the vice foreign minister of China also met the prime minister and the fourth and the fifth king of Bhutan, and also met the foreign minister. So it was a three-day trip, and I think a lot of details would have been discussed, and Doklam would have come in the talks. And, you know, China has been accusing India of meddling in Bhutan's affair. They have been saying that they have been trying to pressure it. They have been diplomatic ties with India. So, in fact, Chinese state media has been actually very openly said that, you know, that India has been meddling in Bhutan's affair and it must stop doing it.
Right. Thank you so much, Gaurav, for that comprehensive update on that crucial meeting between the Chinese foreign minister who's on a visit to Bhutan.